57% of the young people surveyed expressed some level of satisfaction with their body image. But that does mean there's another 43% who didn't express that. That's quite a high percentage, 43%. It's a lot of young people who have concerns in this area. While a majority of all participants say they are satisfied with their body image, almost 2 in 3 say they feel pressurised to look good for other people. More than half say that comparing themselves with others impacts negatively on their body image, and that their body image interferes with their participation in activities such as swimming, dating, and putting their photographs on Facebook. And this seems to reach a high at 15. And I suppose you could say some of this is about growing up and about being a teenager. And it is good to see that as young people get older, that the body image and self-confidence and self-esteem begins to come back again. But it does point to particular issues for that sort of mid-teen years and the need for sensitivity in relation to it and helping young people to cope with this particular period. It's clearly a very vulnerable time for many young people.
Was there any particular findings that you found particularly worrying or surprising?
Well, I won't say that I was particularly surprised, but I was saddened that what I had probably believed might be the case, which is that girls are more negatively impacted by external influences and feel worse about their body image than boys. But that was confirmed in this research and has been shown all around the world in research from other countries, both in the Western world and increasingly in the developing world. The body image is becoming a very big concern for young people, and some of the problems with having a negative body image can be quite serious, such as eating disorders. And we heard today from a member of Bodywise that just as body image satisfaction is lowest at the age of 15 in this survey, that they also find that that's the average onset age for eating disorders. So again, it all kind of builds up a big picture of what the issues are for young people in Ireland.
Well, I suppose the most shocking finding that I found was how the amount of young men who use smoking as an aid to weight loss. We didn't expect that. We didn't expect that to come from the findings. So certainly it shows the kind of the misconceptions that are there in regards to the influence on young people's body image, and it shows the need for such a report to find out factual data regarding what are the influence and what are the kind of the extent young people go to ameliorate their body image.
As I was saying, girls and boys have a different they have different opinions about body image. Boys are more satisfied with their body image than girls, and across a range of activities they're less likely to be put off taking part because of poor body image, whereas girls are up to 4 times as likely as boys to not take part in things like swimming, putting their pictures on Facebook, going out dating, going out with their friends, and those kinds of things. So it can have really serious impacts on their everyday life.
Research evidence worldwide confirms that girls are significantly more influenced by their body image than boys. Put simply, girls want to be thinner, boys want to be more muscular, and both genders struggle to meet these idealised standards, while their body image suffers from the failure of these attempts.
Part of promoting positive body image in schools is getting away from the idea that body image is about how fat you are, how thin you are, how muscular you are. It's not about any of those things. It's about the way you feel about how your body is and about the way you feel about how other people see you. So it's an emotional, it's a mental health issue, and the impacts of poor body image are impacts that are felt in the mental health arena.
What kind of a difference do you think this report can make now?
Well, I think, as Mr. Fitzgerald said, people will know that they're not alone in the way they feel. I mean, there was never really a minority of like 1% saying one thing and then the rest saying another thing. There was always, you know, two halves or whatever. So people know that half the young people surveyed feel the same as them, and that they're not alone in the way they feel. The way they feel isn't weird or unusual. It is common for young people to feel this way, and it does need to change.
I think there'll be a kind of relief maybe for many young people when they hear about this survey, because, you know, they realise it's not just them, this is a social issue that a lot of their peer group are also experiencing. And I think once you begin to name a problem and you begin to draw back the curtain, there is a relief for the young person in that. And I think that's what this survey is doing, that it's a little bit about, you know, breaking away. We're all aware of social pressures, but when you break the silence about it and you say young girls aren't going swimming because they're so worried about body image, well, my goodness, there's certainly a pressure on schools to examine this and make sure that they deal with it and take steps to ensure that young girls are taking part in swimming exercise and physical exercise classes, and that the barrier there isn't just left and not dealt with.
Well, I think ultimately there needs to be a change in social attitude regarding how we think people should openly discuss these sort of matters. For example, we found that that a lot of young men have issue talking openly about how they are affected by body image and how it affects them and how important it is to them, because these would be considered effeminate issues to talk about. So certainly I think ultimately we need a change in that kind of attitude.